We got love that we'll never need to hide. Love will always rise above. Whatever comes, we will be just fine. If I am yours and you are mine, take my hand and let's fly away to another galaxy. Hold me close, I want to feel your love. Together we are free. Just be with me. Just be with me. Just be with me. Now we're one with the sun over our heads, and at night we'll be the stars. We can go any place that we want to. I don't care if that's too far. Take my hand and let's fly away to another galaxy. Hold me close, I want to feel your love. Together we are free. Just be with me. 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 Just be with me.
coming up first, we have the parents of the groom, Tim and Lisa Coleman. Next, we have parents of the bride, Greg and Gina Tolbert. We have the ring bearer and flower girls, Kit Temple and Allison and Jane Coven. Big round of applause, aren't they beautiful? All right, moving on to the bridal party, we have Sarah Showalter, Trevor Belton, Ashley Lindhart. Let's give it up for the best man and maid of honor, Justin Lickier and Chelsea Tolbert.
Your business if you want some, take some, get it together, baby.
Come and get your ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to need you to stand to your feet and please get loud and let's make a ton of noise for your bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Jimmy Coleman.
you that don't know me, I'm Morgan's older sister and her maid of honor. Thankfully, we are each other's only sister, which guaranteed me to be the maid of honor at least one time. Anyway, this would make Morgan my little sister, meaning that at a young age, it was my job to make her life as miserable as possible. Oftentimes, this included pinning her on the ground and chasing her around the house. Morgan tolerated a lot for me growing up. As the oldest, I felt that I was the one in charge, the one who got to make difficult decisions, and the leader of the house in respect to the siblings. Morgan also followed along to things like, hey, I think you should go touch that spider to see if it's still alive. Or, hey, you should run down that rock pile as fast as you can. Or maybe you should give your Barbie bangs. And to my surprise, she often followed through with these tasks because she trusted me. As Morgan got a little older, things started to change. She started to find her voice. I no longer always got the front seat. Then we had this weird system of alternating odd and even days, which was always funny. I no longer was a sports star, as she excelled in volleyball and was one of the only freshmen that could hang with the seniors once transitioning into public school. After college, Morgan was brave in moving to Richmond to pursue her dream of becoming a nurse, even if that meant continuing to date long distance. Thankfully for me, that means that we got to be roommates again, which is really fun. Our nights together consisted of cooking meals, splitting a cold beer after a long day of work, staying up and encouraging each other while we studied, or crying together after venting about difficult patient situations. Growing up, I was usually the one giving advice, but we definitely started to switch roles. Thanks. No matter how much I vented or was upset, Morgan always brought me back down and has always been able to find something good in the hardest of situations. She was a great role model in the way she carries herself, the way she communicates how she feels, while also taking into consideration always the emotions of everyone else. You truly have been an inspiration to me, a great example to your fellow staff, family, and friends that are present today. I'm gonna make it through. We're almost done. I didn't think anyone could love my sister more than I do, but then Jamie came along and changed all of that. I would say welcome to the family, but you've been a brother to us for so long, so far. You're such a hard worker, motivational influencer, competitive athlete, and leader to everyone. There's a quote from the Muppets Christmas Carol which says, If you want to know the measure of a man, you simply count his friends. And by looking around today, I can easily say that you know how to win friends and influence people, and it comes so naturally to both of you. Now, I have to give some obligatory wedding advice. My list is not as long as Father Rollo's. Number one, it's better to have peace than to be right. Number two is always.
What?
What? Tell the truth. We were always told when we were growing up, always tell the truth. That's what we were told when we were younger. Yes, always tell the truth, but actually I was gonna say to always be kind to one another, to friends, when serving other people, and when it comes to forgiving one another. No matter what wedding I go to, I always write the same thing, and that's to put Jesus at the center of your relationship, and you will never go wrong. Jimmy, thank you for loving Morgan, even at her worst, because I know Tolbert girls are a handful. Will can say attest to that, too. Morgan talks about how much she could not have imagined her life without you, and I'm excited to see where the Lord takes both of you, and I could not be more proud of the people that you have become. I'm so thankful to have the opportunity to be your older sister and to be by your side on your wedding day. So let's raise a glass. Oh, sorry. And cheers.
So I don't know if Jimmy has told you guys how he chose the best man. So I'm gonna give you a little bit of the story. He might deny it. It's up to you guys to believe it or not. But what Jimmy did is he actually went to the smartest man that he knew and asked him, will you be my best man? But the guy said no. Say what? Oh, okay, got you. Okay. So then what he did is he went to the funniest man he knew, and that guy also said no. But then he went to the most handsome man he knew, and after I was asked three times, I said, okay, all right, Jimmy, let's do this. I will be here for you, my man. Oh, man. That's right. Completely kidding. No, seriously, though, I'm convinced that in another lifetime, Jimmy and I were best friends, and we grew up in diapers. And even though that isn't the case, I do hope that we continue to be best friends and business partners until we're old and in diapers again. We'll see. Hopefully, it will ride it out. So a little bit of background. Jimmy and I just 4 years ago became friends. He actually reached out to me a million times on a platform that he's known for, which would be LinkedIn. And this isn't like a match.com. This isn't like a match.com kind of story. But what really happened is that we sat down for 30 minutes. It turned into 2.5 hours long, and that is when that's where the bromance occurred. So just a few short months after that, we actually moved 300 miles away to Charlotte, North Carolina. And we built a business together and spent 16 hours a day together for 3 years. After only knowing each other for a couple months, which I look back on it and I'm like, man, dude, there's about a 99.9% chance that this would have never worked. We got completely lucky. We just winged it. But we both kind of came from small towns. We both had huge dreams. We both put the Lord first in every single thing that we did. And I think really it was the competitive spirit that we both had that we will do whatever it takes to win at whatever we do together. There's many commendable traits when it comes to Jimmy, and I could go over a lot of these. However, the number one thing that comes to my mind is competition whenever I think of Jimmy in many ways. And I don't know if you guys have ever played board games with this man, but you got two options, okay? So one option is you're on his team, but if you let him down, you will never hear the end of it. He might not talk to you the rest of the day. It's gonna really hurt the relationship. You should probably not be on his team. Or on the opposite side, you go against him and you're almost guaranteed you're gonna lose. So you're in a bad place either way. No, but seriously, I was sitting back and I was thinking about it, and everybody who meets Jimmy falls in love with him and has a crazy amount of respect for this guy. I was thinking of some things. I mean, this guy does wing-eating competitions. He does Spartan races. He's on the board of a recovery high school, gives speeches at graduations, pours into young kids in his free time, goes to church 2 times almost every Sunday, and he does it all while having a six-pack. So I respect it tremendously, and it pisses me off because there's a lot I gotta live up to on the other side. He's truly a man's man. But really, there's no doubt that Jimmy is obsessed with personal growth and being better at all times. And I think we can all agree that just by having him in our lives, we all have to be better in every area. And it's not even that he's obsessed with progression. It's also his consistency in everything that he does. There's many mornings I wake up and it's 6 a.m. or 5 a.m. and I'm like, I'm not going to work out. But I know Jimmy's not going to miss that workout, so my butt is going to be there every single morning. And I look up to you a ton for that, Jimmy. Seriously, I can't say that enough, and I'm blessed to have you in my life. Other traits that come to my mind as I'm wrapping up is Jimmy has an unconditional loyalty to friends and family. I've noticed that over the many years. He always puts them first, always thinking about them, and always goes out of his way, whether it's easy or not. It's also his selflessness and how much he cares. Anytime someone asks him to do something, if it betters the community, if it betters other people's lives, he's going to say yes and then figure it out later. His honesty. You were talking about be honest always. I can't think of one time Jimmy's ever fibbed. And if I ever exaggerate, he's going to call me out on that exaggeration. 56, the number's 56, not 58, and I appreciate that accountability a ton. It's also his support, like I said, in every aspect of the word. And lastly, it's also his biggest, he's got the biggest heart of anyone I've ever met. He is constantly there for people that he loves. And last but not least, what I've learned over the last 3 years is that he has the most fanatical love in the world for Morgan Coleman. I remember meeting you, Morgan, and I instantly understood why Jimmy was so enamored by you. You do a fantastic job of bringing down walls that people have. You make them want to open up and tell you stuff that they've never told anyone in their lives. Your undeniable support, it like blows my mind. You let Jimmy and I work a million hours a week and have been so patient and so supportive the whole entire time. And your gentleness and caring heart is just truly incredible. So I want to wrap up by us making a toast. I'm going to grab a water, Sally, because I'm not drinking. But I want to leave you guys with one thing, and this has always rocked my world since I've read this, and I want to tell you guys this, is that love is a force more impressive than any other because it is invisible. It cannot be seen, but it can transform you in a moment and offer you more joy than any material possession ever could. I love you guys. Cheers. Thank you. Love you guys.
I drove a long way to get here. Probably not as long as I put up with Jimmy and Morgan and here and Jimmy. It's crazy. But it took a lot of time out of your lives to be here. And you're here for a reason. When the wedding party was getting reduced down to those people who really matter, each of you made the cut. So, toast yourself. Woo! And thank you. I know there's lots of good wedding class people out there. By the way, this is not the end of the party, this is the beginning of the party. Just a little bit, the DJ's going to crank it up. The bar's going to start flowing. We have to bring the heaters in. We'll bring them in, we'll fire them up. Plan on being here as long as you want to be here. But there's an old saying about true love that I haven't heard either of these two people talk about, but I think is the most important thing you can hear. True love is a lot like peeing your pants. Everybody can see it. Only you know the true warmth. So when you leave tonight, you know, look at the person next to you that's a part of your life, and God knows how blessed I am to have Gina. Gina truly is the pee in my pants. And she's been working for 30, over 30 years. If you haven't met my wife, stop and do so. Seriously. You'll feel warm too. Anyway, I really just want to say thank you. The beer's paid for, the liquor's paid for, later there may be some shine. There may or may not be some venison Slim Jims on the bar later on, if you want some free-range organic meat. And also, you know, these vendors have been amazing to work with. You know, this is the second wedding. Lord knows Chelsea came out, the photographer, and did the first shoot, and I said, hey, you know, we got another opening coming up, opening day of bow season. She found a way to be here. And Dwayne, the caterer, God bless him. DJ Gary is here representing DJ Major out of Fredericksburg. Even though he's been playing some soft eating music, he brought some game. So the videographer, Kira, my guy, bless him. You know, so if any of y'all getting married this week or the week thereafter, look these vendors up. They made the cut as well. But largely, I just want to thank you to you. We love Jimmy. We love Morgan. If you've got a little girl, you saw some daddy tears today, you understand. And everyone else that looks around and says, why is that 50-year-old man crying? You'll get it. If you've got a little girl, you'll get it. And if you don't, there's no pee in your pants. Sorry you missed that opportunity. Anyway, thank you for being here. We're going to dance, we're going to drink, we're going to light it up, and I'm glad each of y'all are here. God bless you. Toast to yourselves.
Been losing all momentum. Just because it's easy, that don't make it better. I wanna dig. street if I'm feeling dessert. All of this convenience just doesn't work for me. I wanna play with fire, let me get hurt. Can we take it back to 95? Before we had this drama in our lives, just staring at the screen every day and night. I miss the rush of living in real life. Go get your DeLorean. But sons and daughters was amazing. Can we take it back to 95? Before we had this drama in our lives, just staring at the screen every day and night. I miss the rush of living in real life. Go get your DeLorean. Candy cigarettes and a Playboy mag. Man, you used to have to work for that. Wait for me, gotta dial up. Can't call my landline cause it's all tied up. Just bike over then.